What if the stories passed down for generations, the ones dismissed as myths, were actually pinpoint accurate historical records? And what if science, the ultimate skeptic, suddenly proved them right? That's exactly what just happened. You know Chaco Canyon, right? Those incredible, mysterious ruins in the desert Southwest? For decades, we've debated who built them, what happened to them, and the Pueblo people, like the Picuris Pueblo in New Mexico, have always said, "We are connected to that place. We've always been here." Many scientists? Well, they weren't so sure. Until now. Because brand new genetic research, literally published today, April 30th, 2025, just dropped a bombshell. DNA evidence confirms the Picuris Pueblo's oral history, linking them directly to the people of Chaco Canyon hundreds of years ago. Let's break down what they found. Scientists, working with the Picuris Pueblo, managed to get ancient DNA from 16 individuals buried at Picuris between 500 and 700 years ago. They compared this ancient DNA to samples from 13 living Picuris members. The result? A clear, unbroken genetic line. The people living in Picuris today are direct descendants of those who lived there centuries ago, just like their oral history always said. But here's the kicker. That ancient Picuris DNA also showed a close genetic link to people buried way back at Pueblo Bonito, one of the main sites right in Chaco Canyon. We're talking about a direct genetic tie stretching over hundreds of kilometers and hundreds of years, connecting the heart of the ancient Chaco world to the ancestors of today's Picuris Pueblo. They even found a specific maternal lineage, a mitochondrial DNA line, present in Chaco, in the ancient Picuris ancestors, and in Picuris people living right now. As one Picuris leader put it, this is paper validation for what their elders knew all along. It's science catching up to traditional knowledge. Okay, so we have a direct genetic link. Cool, but why does this really matter? Because it forces us to throw out some old history books about the Southwest. For years, the common story was that Chaco Canyon collapsed around 1150 CE, its society vanished, and people scattered. Maybe, some thought, the ancestors of people like the Picuris arrived much later, filling an empty space. This new DNA evidence says, nope. First, continuity, not collapse. The ancestors of the Picuris were already living in their area by around 900 CE, and they stayed put right through the Chaco decline and beyond. Their population seems to have held steady at around 3,000 people even after Chaco's great houses were abandoned. There wasn't some mass exodus or replacement event, at least not here. They persisted. It wasn't necessarily a collapse in flight. Maybe it was more like a planned downsizing, people leaving the big center to build smaller, independent villages, carrying that Chacoan heritage forward continuously. Second, this study busts the myth of a major pre-contact population crash at Picuris. Some historians speculated that maybe drought or warfare decimated Pueblo populations before Europeans showed up. But the genetic diversity in the ancient Picuris samples stays high and stable right up until the 1500s. The crash came after colonization. The study estimates the Picuris population plummeted by a devastating 85% following Spanish arrival in the mid-1500s, dropping to only about 300 people by 1700. It wasn't some mysterious ancient apocalypse. It was the well-documented horror of colonization, disease, and violence. Before that, they were resilient. And third, it helps settle the debate about when Athabascan peoples, the ancestors of today's Navajo and Apache, arrived in the Southwest. Some theories, based on shaky evidence, suggested they might have been mingling with Pueblo people much earlier, maybe around 1000 CE. This DNA analysis found zero trace of Athabascan ancestry in any Picuris individuals before about 1535. Only after that date does a small amount appear. This strongly supports the idea, backed by Navajo oral tradition too, that Athabascans arrived relatively late, likely around the 15th or 16th century. Their arrival was an overlay onto an already ancient Pueblo world, not an early entanglement. So the big picture is changing. Instead of collapse and replacement, we see continuity and resilience. The Picuris Pueblo weren't just witnesses to history. Their ancestors were the history, adapting and surviving in place for over 1,000 years. This brings us to the most profound part, the validation of oral history. Think about it. For generations, Picuris elders told stories of their origins, their travels, their connection to Chaco. Stories saying, we emerged here, we settled here around 900 CE, we are linked to those great houses. And for generations, many outsiders, including scientists, treated these accounts as legends, symbolism, maybe not literal truth. Some even argued modern pueblos had no direct connection to sites like Chaco. Now DNA comes along and says, the stories were right. The timing matches the archaeology. The genetic lineage confirms the descent and the Chaco connection. As Science News put it, genetic evidence now backs up what Picuris people, but not archaeologists, knew all along. Remember that other video we did, exploring ancient stories that turned out to be true? This is another powerful example happening right now. This isn't just symbolic, it's a form of justice. Indigenous knowledge dismissed for so long is being shown to be accurate and reliable. Lieutenant Governor Craig Quancello, a co-author on the study, said, our elders knew we had always been here, but it was very moving and powerful to see it validated on paper that we have a maternal genetic link to Chaco Canyon. For the community, it's deeply affirming, and it has real-world impact. Picuris and other pueblos have been fighting to protect Chaco Canyon from things like oil and gas drilling, arguing it's their sacred ancestral land. When their oral testimony was ignored, their fight was harder. Now they have hard scientific data backing them up. It's tougher to dismiss their claims when the DNA says unequivocally, yes, these are their ancestors' lands. In fact, frustration over being ignored in the Chaco fight is what spurred Picuris leaders to seek out geneticists in the first place. This isn't the first time DNA has backed up indigenous oral history. Remember the Kennewick man, the ancient one? Remains over 8,000 years old. Northwest tribes insisted he was their ancestor. Initial studies doubted it. Then in 2015, DNA proved the tribes right. Aboriginal Australian stories recount events tens of thousands of years old, volcanic eruptions, sea level rise, later confirmed by geology and genetics. The fidelity of oral tradition can be astonishing. It's kind of ironic, isn't it? Science, which sometimes demanded DNA proof from tribes, generating mistrust, is now finding that the DNA often supports the oral histories against earlier scientific speculation. It's causing a shift. More researchers are realizing that oral tradition and science aren't enemies, but partners. They can be complementary ways of knowing the past. This study also highlights how science should be done with indigenous communities. In the past, it was often exploitative. Scientists took samples, sometimes against tribal wishes, pursued their own questions. This Picuris project flipped the script. The tribe initiated it, the tribe directed it, they invited the scientists, set the terms, controlled the process, and retained sovereignty over their ancestors' genetic data. They worked with top ancient DNA expert Eske Willerslev's lab, but only after 2 years of consultation to build trust. They approved which ancestral remains could be sampled. 16 individuals excavated back in the 60s and stored in a museum. They decided what could be published, protecting sacred knowledge. This wasn't science on the Picuris people. It was science by and for the Picuris people. Contrast that with a controversial 2017 Chaco DNA study done without consulting descendant communities. This new project even reanalyzed that older data, but this time under Picuris authority, reclaiming the narrative. This collaborative model is a breakthrough. It respects sovereignty, ensures ethical conduct, and frankly, probably leads to better science because it incorporates community knowledge. Those 16 ancestors, stored away for decades, are now recognized, their stories told, and they can be reburied with honor, their place in the lineage confirmed. That's powerful. It's a model for healing and empowerment, showing science can be an ally. So what happens next? This study opens up so many doors and questions. If Picuris oral history about Chaco is this accurate, what about other Pueblo nations, Hopi, Zuni, Taos, Acoma, who also have oral traditions linking them to Chaco or other ancient sites? Could collaborative DNA studies, if those communities desire them, confirm their specific connections too, painting an even richer picture of the past? Will this scientific validation strengthen legal and cultural claims for protecting sacred sites like Chaco? Will it help in repatriating ancestral remains under laws like NAGPRA, providing clear evidence of affiliation where it was previously debated? How will this affirmation boost identity and pride within Picuris Pueblo and inspire other indigenous communities? Will it encourage more young people to learn and trust their traditional histories? Will academia truly shift, giving more weight to oral tradition in historical research, adopting this collaborative model as the standard? Imagine history books telling the story of the Southwest using archaeology, genetics, and the rich tapestry of indigenous oral accounts side by side. And there are new scientific mysteries. The DNA shows the connection, but how exactly did it happen? Did a specific group migrate from Chaco to Picuris around 900 CE? Or was it more about long-standing ties through marriage and ceremony? What drove people to leave the Chaco hub? Was it escaping hierarchy, seeking autonomy, as some suggest? What about before 900 CE? How far back does this genetic continuity go? And the interactions with later arriving Athabascan groups? The DNA confirms late arrival and some later admixture. How did those relationships play out on the ground? Oral histories from both sides might hold clues that genetics can now help investigate. This isn't just a local story. It echoes globally. Indigenous peoples worldwide have ancient narratives. Polynesia, Scandinavia, the Amazon, Africa. Could respectful collaborative science help illuminate the histories preserved in those traditions too? The Picuris people knew their history. Now, thanks to their initiative, using the cutting-edge tools of genomics, that history is confirmed in a way the outside world can no longer ignore. Science didn't discover their past, it provided a translation. Makes you wonder, what other truths, dismissed as myth, are just waiting for us to finally listen and maybe find a new way to see? Keep digging with us for the next discovery. You never know what we'll find.